and students all over India to enhance their knowledge by listening to the stalwarts of homeopathy. This webinar series will be continued up to 4th August 2020. It's my privilege to welcome our administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krasta, Principal Dr. Shiv Prasad K, Vice Principal Dr. ESJ Prabhukiran for this session today. I also welcome the speaker for today's session, Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, who is here to speak on the topic Delusions and Genes, Mind Behind Pathology, Autism. I welcome the moderator for today's session, Dr. Rajachandra G, Associate Professor, Department of Medicine. I request the moderator to take over the session. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Helena. So it is our proud privilege to welcome one of our own alumnus, Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, for today's evening session. So first and foremost, before I introduce Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, it's my responsibility to introduce his topic for today. Dr. Divya Kumar Verma is speaking today on a very, very important area of homeopathic practice, that is understanding the mind. I quote from Hanuman's Organon itself, that is from the aphorism 16, where Master Hanuman himself mentions or acknowledges the concept of dynamic morbid perception that insults the vital force to disease. In the footnote, he again explains that a spirit-like vital force cannot be damaged or destroyed by the external material factors, and he goes to explain that it can be only damaged or destroyed by the spirit-like dynamic abnormal perceptions. So that is what we understand today as a delusion, abnormal thoughts, abnormal feelings. Okay, so again, I would like to quote from another very important person. He says, "This universe is not an assembly of physical parts, but instead comes from entanglement of immaterial energy waves." When you hear this, we think some Babaji or some very philosopher, great philosopher must have used these words, but these words come straight from Albert Einstein. Similar thoughts are shared by Max Planck and Wegener Heisenberg. So these people also acknowledge that there is something very dynamic. So today we have with us Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, who will be enlightening us with regard to the aspects of mind and the importance of considering the mind in homeopathic prescription. So before we actually get into the topic, I would like to introduce this gentleman, Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, who actually completed his homeopathy and then came here to pursue his post-graduation from Father Muller Homeopathic Medical College. I should tell you that he was one of the very inspiring students here at Father Muller's. Whenever we see him, there are two things: very well-dressed and very soft-spoken gentleman in the campus. And even today when I speak to somebody, for example, Sergeant always remembers, when I wear a stethoscope around my neck, he says, "Are you imitating Dr. Divya Kumar Verma?" So he has, one word he used to say, that is, "Hum bhi kar sakte hai." That is one word which most often I used to hear from his mouth. "Hum kyun nahi kar sakte? Hum bhi kar sakte. We can do it." That is the one word which he constantly used to tell us. Presently, he is the senior homeopathic medical officer, a grade 2 from government of Rajasthan. He has 10 years of clinical experience through classical Hanumanian homeopathy. People used to say classical Hanumanian homeopathy from the private practice, but Dr. Divya Kumar Verma is doing the same thing even in his government dispensary. Awards received. Dr. Divya Kumar Verma is appreciated on several occasions. State level certificate of appreciation on Hanuman's Day. For his execution of duties as a doctor, certificate of appreciation from BGen Pharmaceutical Private Limited, certificate of appreciation from excellent work in Arogya Mela by Rajasthan government. He has published over 9 papers. And I have to explain, there are so many things. Then I'll straight away go to his paper presentation. One of the things which I was attracted to his paper presentations are his titles. Very unique titles he has selected: Understanding the Molecular Mechanism Behind Homeopathy, My Experiments with Repertory. I know from where it is inspired, this title. Repertorial Approach to Low Back Pain, Management of Stress by Herbal Medicine, The Role of Homeopathy in Sports Injuries, some scientific experiments unexplained, and role of homeopathy in pain management, and so on. So many papers he has published, and so many papers he has presented. And he is also inspiring many young homeopaths, including me, with his YouTube channel, which has already 608 subscribers. There are so many YouTube channels running on explanation related to diseases, but there are very few homeopaths excelling in the field of homeopathy, talking about homeopathy and gaining the subscribers. So coming to his self-publication, as if it is not sufficient, he has also started one bulletin on his own strength, and that is the Homeopathy, the Nanomedicine of Future from 2017. He is organizing several medical camps, his favorite zone, that is autism, cerebral palsy, and genetic disorders in various places in Udaipur, Rajasthan. He is a life member of Society for Microbiota Research and Integrated Medicine. I thought this particular area he might have not encroached, but he has already done it. That is research in the integrated medicine. And he is also fellow of Society for Microbiota Research and Integrated Medicine. So now I am breathless. I will check my pulse oximeter with these few words. And dear Dr. Divakumar Verma sir, we are very happy from Fadamula Homeopathic Medical College to invite you once again for our new platform, that is this webinar series. Today we have entered into a new phase of lockdown, but in Fadamulas we are not yet knocked down. So dear Dr. Divakumar Verma sir, the floor is open to you. Please start the session.
Thank you, Dr. Raja. First of all, extremely feeling emotional after seeing all the staffs and all the history. Again, fascinates me, the history of Father Muller Homeopathy College and institution actually fascinated me. That is why I came over here. And in this respect, first of all, I remember my guru, Dr. S.K. Tiwari, sir, and all the staff members with whom I used to be associated with. I remember Dr. Chakravarti, sir, Dr. Kamat, sir, Dr. Shiv Prasad, sir, our PG coordinator, our Valarmati ma'am, Rita ma'am, and my esteemed senior, Dr. Kurian, sir. So I remember all, and it's been a long time, but I do remember all, and that Kannada is still running in my brain. So, to begin with the topic, I'll start the slide sharing. Yes, delusions and genes. These two things are a totally different phenomena, which medical science is not at all accepting, but for us homeopaths, it is very, very important. Now, what does delusion and genes? Actually, we are human beings and our system is not running in a physical mode. The physical mode is one aspect, that is the anatomy and physiology, but this anatomy and physiology need to be controlled by some particular central force. And what is this central force? This central force is our mind, or in subtle sense, we say that it is our perception. So this perception is very, very important. Say, for example, a cell is exposed to certain stimuli. A negative environment is being exposed to a cell. Then this particular cell has an intelligence whether to move towards that trigger or whether to move away from that trigger or stimuli. So each and every cell of our body have intelligence. We are intelligent being. We are having certain energy forms. We are certain energy forms, and we are nothing like physical entities. We are quantum beings. So the laws of physical physics, or the laws of physics, which is at the level of the physical reality, it does not apply to our human body. The qu- quantum physical laws are only applying to our human body. So in the human body, nothing can happen as a physical form. Everything has to be coming from the direction, under the direction and the guidance of our central force, and which we call it as mind. So whenever any, we have so many trillion cells and all are functioning in a harmonious way. So there is a central program. So this body is like a hardware, and the software which is running is in the mind. So this software is guiding the physical body so as to form a proper physiology to perform regularly in a harmonious way. Now, whenever there is a virus in our software program, virus means any negative thought which comes in our perception. These negative thoughts, they tend to influence the central mechanism, and thereby that negative signal is transmitted into the hardware and the body starts reacting according to that thought process. You know, whatever we think, this the consciousness or whatever our perception is, the physical body tries to follow that. There are several experiments which have proved that our consciousness can alter our reality. So there are many experiments, but the conventional science, they do not agree with that. But there are experiments which are there. So it has been proven that your DNA is connected with your fellow DNA by some unknown mechanism. If your DNA is here, and if your body is here, and if your DNA is in, suppose, in Mangalore, so that DNA and this body is connected by certain mechanism. And it has been proven that no matter wherever you are, whatever perception you are feeling over here, that same perception will be felt by your cell, which is hundreds and thousands of kilometers away. So this perception is very, very important. So now the vital question is, where is this perception and in the cell? Where is the mind of the cell? So the mind of the cell lies in the cell membrane. So this area of the cell, which is exposed to the outside environment, it perceives and it sends signal. It is not the nucleus, which is the mind of the cell, mind you. It is not the nucleus, which is the mind of the cell. It is the cell membrane, which perceives the outside signal and thereby gives the signal inside, and the response is being elicited. Cell can survive if at all the nucleus is removed. Cell even can survive without DNA. But without cell membrane, cell cannot survive. So I'll start with a case. So this child, age 6 years, it came to me with a hyperactive disorder, difficulty in reacting, very few sounds uttered, hearing was completely normal. And the mother says, this child was not at all active, not at all responding to any stimuli, like a typical autistic or ADHD child. So now this mother says that this child had a history of boils on the head and hip, which were treated by a dermatologist. And after 2 months, this child developed hyperactivity, and this child developed symptoms of ADHD. So now this child is the second child. Elder sister is completely normal. So this lady had to do the second issue under pressure from in-laws, because husband was financially not secure. And these in-laws were trying to impose that they should do a second child, because the elder child was a daughter. So now they wanted that another child should be there and they should conceive again. So after getting pregnant, so this lady consulted gynec, and they were doing a regular checkup, and the gynec said that everything is fine, no problem. So they were living in the staff quarter. So now, what was the nature of this child? So this child did not took breastfeed till 5 days of the delivery. And if someone speaks harshly with anyone, he weeps. Even before his sister weeps, he weeps very early. He likes to see books. He likes to see the pictures in the books. When the whole family is there, when people are there in the family, so he is very happy. So another thing which mother said, that this child likes to be caressed very nicely. This child wants to be caressed. So now what is to be done with this child? What should be our approach? I want doctors to be interactive. Yes, please. What is the plan? What need to be done? Yes, thoughts of mother during pregnancy, family counseling, predisposing factors. Yes, very nice. Constitutional. Now, what constitution should be looked upon here is important. The child's constitution is like this. So now we have to repair this constitution. Mother during pregnancy and child's nature. Very nice, Dr. Hema. Thoughts of and feelings of mother. ANC history, mother's history during pregnancy. Yes. So as I already said, that there is a problem in the child, and because the physical body or the physical or the physiology of the child is being affected as a genetic basis. Usually these autism or ADHD, the symptoms develop late, and the parents and even we doctors, we tend to skip the diagnosis. So these symptoms, they develop later on in the life. So what is being affected is the physiology. So now what is important is, why is this physiology got disturbed? So here the effect is in the child, but the cause lies in the mother.
So what I decided was, why is the constitution of child like this, and what disturbed the development of this child? So as Dr. Rajachandra has nicely said about aphorism 16. So very, very important this aphorism is, particularly
the last line. Most severe disease may be produced by sufficient disturbance of the vital force through the imagination and also cured by the same means. So Hahnemann has clearly written and mentioned in this aphorism that the cause is always dynamic, and it is usually the imagination. So why are we suffering? We are suffering because of the past life, life which we have lived, as well as the future which we are thinking upon. So the past should be past. Why it is affecting us now? So our perception is the cause of our disease. So now, what about the maternal stress history? First of all, husband was not earning well. Second, now another important aspect here is, when we are looking in the pregnancy history, so what time of the pregnancy should be looked upon? That is very, very important. Yes, please. Vaccination history to be considered. Fine. First trimester. Okay. Maternal history during pregnancy and vaccination history. Okay. Late pregnancy, where the mother felt more stress. Okay. Second and third trimester. After fourth month, third trimester. First 3 months, after fourth month, does she really want that child? Very nice question. See, this lady, she was under stress whether I should continue, because she did not wanted to do further issue, but she was forced upon. But the effect on the child is the development is completely normal. I mean, the anatomy of this child is completely normal. The brain size is normal. Everything is normal. Only thing which is disturbed is the functional physiology. So there are certain things in the physiology which have not yet developed. Or you can say in a local term that certain circuits or certain neuronal connections have not been developed. So now what is to be seen here is, when does this physiology develops? So the physiology of the brain develops after the later pregnancy comes. So in the later part of the pregnancy, the physiology or the neuronal connection happens. So in these cases, what we have to see is the later part of the pregnancy and the stress related in the later part of the pregnancy. So now here, baby didn't take feed for 5 days, so it was because of initial rejection by mother. Yes, definitely. Whatever mother thinks will be reflected in the child. Definitely. So at 4th month, mother went to a marriage function where she vomited, and after that she felt that she was not able to move, as if I am zinda lash, as if I'm dead person. In-laws told that there is some negative energy and did not consult it. When her brother came after 7 days, he took her to the doctor and consulted. So doctor said it was just dehydration. She was given drips and she became all right. So see the orthodox thinking of the in-laws over here. Yes, did the mother anytime express it after delivery that it might have affected the child? Mother did not wanted that child because she was already having financial issues. That is for sure.
But she was forced.
So in the last 3 months, there was too much pressure of delivering a boy child. Whenever I used to meet in-laws, they used to say, we want a boy. So this was the pressure which she was feeling. So she could not go to mom's place because there was some problem going on there also. So she could not go to that place also. So she tried to do some calculations with Chinese calendar. It predicted a boy. So she became happy. Then what happened was her husband suddenly left his job and did not tell her over a month that he has left the job. So he wanted to do some travel agency business. But again, there was a financial issue. The financial aid was not available. So father-in-law got retired and he gave 15 lakhs to his other son. And husband was not given anything. So he was just given a shop where he had to sit and then he had to work. Now, what will we do? That was the feeling. Yes, helplessness feeling is definitely there. And she was also working in a chemistry lab. So when I first went to doctor, no one came with me. I got fainted standing in line. When she came home, nobody asked her, what did doctor say? Nobody cares for me being pregnant. So that was the emotional hurt which she received. First was that she was pressurized for a child. And next was that nobody is caring. Yes, helplessness, need support, affection. Yes, abandoned, attention, forsaken feeling. Baby was born with poor socialization and emotional bonding. Definitely, that emotional bonding was definitely lacking. So in the later months, the brother-in-law was getting married. And when she slept at the time of reception, she was not able to get up. She was not able to speak and had to be supported while walking. In-laws thought that she's again in some bad vibes, so started doing all tantra mantra and everything. So now that parents took her to a hospital where again dehydration was diagnosed. And now one question, why again and again her blood pressure is getting lowered? Why she's developing hypotension? What kind of personality will have this hypotension and what kind of personality will have hypertension? Yes. Yes, please, inputs. Anxiety for hopelessness, she's tolerant, anxious. Hypertension for timid, anxious. Yes, definitely. See, hypotension is when the other hormones are more, or you can say that the vascular tone is very, very less, so that the blood flow on the top is very, very less. So all the more when a personality is of a relaxed nature, when a personality is of such a trait who tries to let go of things. So those type of personalities, they tend to have hypotension. Those personality who tend to give up things very easily, so those, they have that tendency of hypotension. People who are chronically stressed out, people who have the habit of taking stress in small, small things, and they have that chronic adrenaline rush always, so those people, they tend to have hypertension, because the effect of the stress directly affects the adrenals and the kidneys. So mostly stressed out people, they are very anxious people, or people who tend to take stress very easily, so they tend to get hypertension. And people who tend to be very relaxed, very give up type of people, okay fine, take this away, okay fine, I'll do this, very mild and yielding and timid people, they tend to go more towards hypotension. Yes. So what this lady was doing here is, so again, that parents, they took her to the hospital and she again was revived. Then she was constantly thinking that, what if I get a girl? How would I face my in-laws? They are so hopeful about boy child. I was having a dream that I delivered a girl child. It was a rural setup, so there was so much pressure. So she was living in a rural setup also. There, the outside environment was very orthodox, very, very hostile environment. So this mother-in-law will kill me if I deliver a daughter. So that much amount of pressure she was feeling. She said, I cried a lot in the last month of pregnancy. So there was a constant crying. So in 9th month, mother-in-law came to live with this lady. So she was always having that angry face, always watching TV and giving lecture. See, I used to do this type of things in pregnancy. We were like this. And now see what kind of pregnancy you are having. So what type of routine you are having. So that always lecture and always taunting was there. So she was always constantly commenting that, see, you will have a girl child. See, you are having this type of things developing in you. Definitely you will have a girl child. So this was the perception which was there in the mind of this lady. So I used to do all the work and she was of no help. So she was just here to show people that, see, I'm here to take care of my daughter-in-law. It was just a show off. And she was more of a burden to her. In her house, there was a custom that pregnant daughters should not be delivered at parents' house, because they had a history that all the cases were getting spoiled and some or the other problem used to happen. So this lady, she was thinking that, I will not go to my mother's place for the delivery. This further, she says that, if I was alone, I would be more happy. Mother-in-law does not talk or sit with me. I was doing job and my daughter was also there. I used to feel exhausted, but she will not help. So that much amount of work she was doing, that mother-in-law was not at all helping her. So I was already tortured because of the previous girl child delivered. So this mother-in-law, why I don't know, always becomes a villain. So I was already tortured because of the previous girl child delivered, except one case which I have seen. So in that case, this lady, she wanted to go to her in-law's place, but she was not allowed by her parents. And that is why the child developed autism. That was one case which I found out. In that case, this pregnant lady, she had a desperate need that she wanted to go to her in-laws' place because she was so much attached to them. But her parents did not allow her to go. So that this child developed autism. There was this one case. So in my mother's place, father had to sell flat and they had to go on rent. Brother was also not getting married. They were already disturbed. So there was issues going on in her mom's place also. So she wanted support of her husband and did not get care as if I am enemy if anytime I demanded something to eat. So she was treated as if she was an enemy whenever she demanded something to eat. Nobody will care for me and will pass comments if I deliver girl child. I will be tortured. So that was the exact words of her. Yes, so much restrictions, forsaken feeling. Actually, what is the difference between forsaken feeling and neglected feeling? See, forsaken feeling is when you need a certain person, you are attached to a certain person, and that person leaves you. That is forsaken feeling. Neglected feeling is if you are not getting attention, that is just a neglect. Yes. So people used to say that it is a fortune to have a child. So that was the comment which she used to hear. I felt like I should die. I cannot tolerate. So that much stress she was feeling. I should die. This is the phase of my life where I should get proper care, but I am being tortured. Yes, tormented feeling. Yes. Tormented feeling, then desires death. Yes. Depression. Yes. Should not be this time. Never ever. Never ever again I used to feel. I should not do this. I should not even remember this time of my life. Never ever. That was the thinking. I feel as if I am very... As if I am very helpless. There is no one to help. My demands are not fulfilled. I am being tortured. No one is caring for me. So I used to feel I am of no use here. Even I cannot meet the physical demands of my husband. I used to feel lonely even though there were people at home. So that was the perception of this lady. So she had a strong history of stress, delusion, friendless, lack of love. Yes. Delusion, conspiracy. Very nice. See, when do you take a delusion, conspiracy? Conspiracy is when something and or the other is going on behind your back. That is conspiracy. See, when you are working in an office, some or the other employee is spreading some rumor or some nonsense things around you, and suddenly you come to know. That is conspiracy. But if the situation is not like that, only it is your perception, then it is delusion, conspiracies. Sir, it is the feeling of the patient or really imposed in law's house. It is the feeling of this patient. Actually, delusion persecuted. See, what is persecuted here? What does persecution mean? Something which is intolerable, which is out of proportion, which you cannot handle. And that thing will finish you off. That is persecution. Like a judge orders a sentence of persecution that finish this. So any problem or any situation which tries to finish you off, that is the perception of the patient, that is delusion persecuted. Say for example, sir, I feel that this eczema is not going to end. I think I have tried so many things. I have tried this, I have tried that, but it is not going to end. I think it will end with my life. Okay. Or I don't know what will happen, or it may aggravate, or it may exaggerate so much that it might kill me. This itching of the eczema is killing me. It is intolerable. That is delusion persecuted. I try to imitate a patient. This lady, she comes with a pain. Sir, I'm having this pain. I'm having this pain in the abdomen. Sir, this pain is there. I'm just calm down. What is happening? Sir, this pain is killing me. So here that feeling is delusion persecuted. The intense pain is giving this perception to the patient that this pain will not allow this patient to survive. This is persecuted. Yes, agony, anguish. Yes, anguish. Despair of recovery. When does the patient say despair of recovery? Doctor, I don't think that my problem will resolve. It is because this, my friend, he brought me here, I've come, but I don't feel that my problem is going to end. So this is despair of recovery. Now, this despair of recovery becomes a common symptom when you are having a incurable disease like cancers or all those sorts of things. So it becomes a common thing. So this, all the more it comes. But if at all it is happening for small pathology or small problem, then it becomes important. Sir, this, what is this allergy, sir? Every time I'm sneezing and sneezing and sneezing, I don't think that any medicine is going to work. I've tried this thing, I tried that thing, but nothing has helped me. So even I've come over here, but I don't think that homeopathy is going to help. So this is despair of recovery. I cannot recover. I will not recover. This despair here means total hopeless state. Total hopeless state. Recovery means re means back, and recovery means again coming back to the normal state. That is not at all possible. So this is despair of recovery. Anticipation is a all the more sorrow psychotic feeling. Okay, then we'll proceed. We'll have want of love is there. I will have some problem if I'm not able to deliver the child, this boy child. I'll have the problem. What problem? All the people from the village, they will taunt me. Then say that my birthday was in October. Nobody wished me. I was crying. I should get a little love and care and talking or saying like this. She was crying. Even after first pregnancy, no one is loving me. And after this, what is going to happen? I was feeling pity on myself that I do not exist in this house. It is as if I'm eating, working, sitting and standing, as if I have no life and who does not have any value. I should die at this time of the delivery, I used to think. So this feeling, this perception of this lady was, I should die, desire love to be. This is more all the more psychotic feeling. Orphaned feeling. See, orphaned feeling one will have when there is a parental shadow which was there earlier, but that shadow has gone. Or the physical presence of parents or any higher member of the family was there and that has gone. So that is orphaned feeling. Worthless is all the more correct. Then identity. Then okay, so it was very big mistake that I conceived. I should die as no one is giving care and value to me. I was living with a family, still I was feeling alone. I should not have conceived, I should have aborted. So now what is the most negative perception here in this lady in the mind that could induce a genetic disorder in the child? What is so negative in this lady, in the mind of this lady? Delusion deserted, delusion wrong suffered. See, delusion wrong suffered, how desires death, yes? Delusion crime committed, why I am pregnant? See, crime committed is when you have done something, when you are having a negative perception about yourself, that I have done something as if I'm a criminal. I've done an act which is all the more criminal. That is delusion, criminal he is. Here she has not done anything, any of this. Blaming herself, yes. This is autoimmunity. Any rubric which is self-destructive, that is autoimmune. Any damn thought if you find in a case which is below autoimmunity, below the level of autoimmunity, any pathology is there. And if you find any negative thought which is related to self, so those autoimmune thoughts are very, very important. You should enter the case with this, reproaching herself. Yes, she is definitely reproaching herself. So yes, now what is so the nature of the child, you know. Yes, please analyze. I have no worth. That is important. I have no value in this house. This is important. Pay attention to what patient is talking about. What could be the deepest level of syphilis or syphilitic thought process here? See, your life is the most important thing which you have in your hands. And that is the most dearest thing which any person should have. Okay. So the rubrics related to life are of the topmost priority. They are very, very important. Yes, I am not existing. Very nice. So your existence in this world is very, very important. What is beyond existence? That is another aspect. So yes, very nice. Contempt for herself. No, this is not contempt. Yes, no identity, right? Yes, yes, yes. Okay. So now, death desires. That was the first syphilitic entry point, clear cut, which is being. See, there are things. There is suicidal disposition. There are suicidal thoughts. Death presentiment of the death desires. Death thoughts of. Then. Death presentiment of. All these rubrics are very, very important. At any point of time, if you have, or if a patient is saying, "Ki, sir, I do not want to live." These are the very, very important syphilitic thought processes. So that is important. Leave everything. Just grab that syphilitic entry point. Yes. Child is affected by thought of mother to abort. Okay. Yes. Second important, what could be the delusion here? I took two rubrics over here. One is death desires. What is the second rubric here? That is very, very important. She doesn't have that self-hate. Yes. She was okay only after suppression of boils. Yes. Whether should we enter from here? Suppression of boils going into this. See, I just want to tell you one thing. Such type of kids, such type of personalities who are MRCP, who are born syphilitic, any damn problem will go into suppression because they are already in a syphilitic state. So any damn thing can go. They can have any damn disease after they are born because their state is syphilitic. So it doesn't matter from where the suppression went to where. Okay. It is what is important here, the syphilitic base, which is very, very important. We have to take care of that syphilitic base. Whatever building is building up on that, that is important. That will be removed once that syphilitic base is identified and prescribed upon. Send away days of grace. No. When this rubric, when you will take is, when a patient is saying, ki, I don't know what is happening. I don't know what is happening. But in this life, I think that I am suffering because I did something in my past life. Because of the consequence of it, in this life, I am suffering. That is delusion, sinned away days of grace. Delusion forsaken is known care for her. See, delusion forsaken, when will you take this rubric will not cater about your genetic disorder. This rubric will treat only if the pathology is at the skin, that too on the ectoderm. If at all the child was having a problem of the ectoderm and that was genetic also, so this entry rubric could be taken, delusion forsaken. So this forsaken is just a separation conflict that is only related to skin and ectoderm. Delusion despised, see, she was not looked down upon. Poor, neglected, love that she is not. See, it is not a delusion that she is not. That is the fact that she is not being loved. Delusion does not exist. Yes, that is the delusion which is working upon. So the rubric which I took was delusion identity error of. Here the perception of this mother is, I do not exist over here. My existence is not at all there. I don't have any value. See, there are, when I'm talking about this rubric, I have treated many, many, many cases on this delusion identity error rubric. With this single rubric, I have treated so many cases, so many cases. I tell you about this. When will you take this delusion identity error off? Number one. A female patient comes to you and says, ki, sir, whatever the problem is, her version is, ki, sir, I've been treated at home as if main ghar ki bai hu, as if I am a servant at home. This is delusion identity error of. Because here the underlying what this patient is trying to say is, ki, my existence or my identity is not recognized. I should be treated as a daughter-in-law. But I am being identified as a servant. Second, if a person is trying to imitate someone, many of the people you might have seen that they are trying to mimic somebody, trying to mimic the voice, certain voice artists are there. So that is again identity. They are trying to identify with someone else. Okay, so that is identity error of. Then another version is yes, people who try to follow certain things, they try to imitate somebody, or if they try to project as if they are someone else, kisi aur ki tarah dress up they are doing, a person who is trying to imitate like Amitabh Bachchan, so that is also identity error of. Because he feels that as a person, I am not being identified in the society. If I try to mimic somebody else, then I will be, taken for granted. So I'll be taken for granted wali feeling. So this is again delusion, identity error of. Okay, yes, hormonal disturbances, very nice. If a male child is, male person is having gynecomastia, this is identity error of. Okay, Klinefelter syndrome. Many of the Klinefelter syndrome mothers, they suffered from identity crisis. That is why the child became like this. Okay, so there is an endless list of identity error. So these are the remedies which came, Lacasse's, Lacan. So different remedies, they have different perceptions. So here Lacasse's, now how do you differentiate and what do you prescribe is very, very important. Death desires is around 50-60 remedies are there. Identity error 17-18, yeah, I think almost 20-25 remedies are there. See, one thing important here is, and never think about superficial emotions. When you are dealing with genetic disorders, superficial emotions are not at all important. Indignation, anger suppressed, not at all important. These things are to be seen in the final selection. Okay, so Lacan, Natremure. See, Natremure personality. What is the Natremure personality? What is Natremure personality is like? Natremure is so much engrossed in a relationship that he loses his identity. That I was a person and I am so much involved in the life of other person, or I am so much attached to the other person that in the bargain I lose myself. That is natremure. Stramonium is out of so much insecurity, trying to cling upon some other person, because I cannot live alone. If I am alone, I don't know from where some negative situation or some negative thing will come and will harm me. That is why I need to be with someone else. That is the stramonium personality. So clinging and identity error. Thuja, identity error is inside Thuja. Thuja is the most manipulative medicine. You will never get a clear-cut Thuja patient anytime. That is my promise. I can write a stamp paper. Thuja patient will never give you a very correct history. Always a manipulative. King of antipsychotic. Everything will be hodgepodge. He will try to manipulate you like this. Whatever he is from inside, he will project the opposite from outside. That is Thuja. That is the identity error of Thuja. Okay, LSD is from some other world he is going. He is roaming here and there. So his identity is not, he does not exist. So he feels that he is not here in this body. He is somewhere else. Then Illumina. Illumina is totally different thing. So he feels that this body is mine, but this head is not mine. Whatever decision I have to take, I have to ask somebody. Yes, Thuja is liar. Yes, definitely. So the head belongs to other is Illumina. So this head, this logic is to be supplied from some other person. Illumina will come and sit. You ask her, see, what is your problem? She'll ask to the attendant. When it is, she'll look to the attendant. Then you'll ask, what is the problem? Are you not remembering? Then attendant says, sir, she's like that. She's confused and all like that. So that is Illumina. With just observation, you'll be able to pick out which is Illumina personality. Yes. So I prescribed this lady Natrum Foss 10M on 3/4/18. This child, Natrum Foss 10M was given because no anatomical defect. We have to give a penetrating dose which should go deeper into the genes. So 10M was the potency. And why Natrum Foss? Because this video is available on YouTube. You can look it up on my YouTube channel also. Yahan pe YouTube ye video chalega kya yahan pe, Dr. Raja?
Yes, sir. You can play the videos. No problem.
Okay. So this was the follow-up which I received.
क्या चेंज आया उसमें नमन में?
हाँ चेंज मतलब अंडरस्टैंडिंग बढ़ी है इसकी, उठने बैठने के तरीके में थोड़ा फर्क आया, जैसे आलसी पालती मार के कभी नहीं बैठता था, अब एक बार अच्छे से बैठ जाता है, इसको बिठाते हैं, हाथ से रोटी से खाना अब थोड़ा थोड़ा शुरू
किया,
घर पे नहीं,
ठीक है,
बाकी स्कूल में भी पहले नहीं खा पाता था, और
Are you able to see the video?
No, we cannot see, sir. One small thing what you can do is play.
Just a second.
Share the screen, sir.
Yeah, new share. I already shared it.
Don't share the...
Okay. Understood. Sorry. where is that video? Yes. Video is not at all visible at first. How to? Okay, I'll remove this.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah.
What you do is just minimize Zoom. Open the video. Now, first, what you should do is you should stop screen sharing, sir. Stop screen sharing.
Okay.
Yeah. Now.
Stop share. Okay.
Yeah. Now minimize the zoom. In the background, you play the video. Okay.
Speech.
Speech.
Is it visible?
Now you start.
Start screen sharing.
No, no, not screen sharing. Share. Now, before Windows, sir.
1 minute, 1 minute. Yes.
Now, you will see only that video. Don't share the entire screen. That video will be there, no?
Okay.
That alone you share it, sir.
Is not in my this sharing this video is not at all visible.
Sir, what is the video name, sir, in YouTube?
Autism related to autism.
Autism.
Yeah.
Oh.
Approach to autism I've written, and in that this video is available.
Okay, you continue, sir. I will try to do that.
Okay. So the latest video is available with me now. Okay. I'll post it on the YouTube, no problem.
Okay.
Yes. So autism and identity error off. So here the, okay, sharing the screen. Yes. So this child, here the identity of the mother was getting affected at home. So this lady, she gives a genetic message to the genes of the child. She informs the genes of the child that that thing will also happen to you. Your existence is not at all useful in this house. Because number one, if you are a girl child, then they will not accept you. Second, even though if you are born, I do not exist in this place. So the same thing may happen to you. Now, this hyperactivity in this child is why? Because mother wanted to escape from this environment, but she could not. So in the autism, multiple factors are there from multiple areas that affects the mother. And you have to analyze all the factors, and then you have to find out which is the most syphilitic aspect in that, which is the most deepest syphilitic aspect, which is the thought process or the perception of the mother. So that thing we have to take. She could not retaliate, so the voice of the child is lost. She could not say anything. She was so much forced. She could not communicate. She could not talk to her husband also that I do not want. Even the husband was not at all communicating. He left the job and did not inform the life partner also. So here the natrum foss. Now, why would a mother give birth to natrum foss child? What should be the background? This is for our retrospective study of the remedy. Number one, when there are relationship issues, so that natrum comes. Second, when there is a communication issue. Combine these two and you will get the natrum foss personality. Do not want to burden others who are already disturbed. So natrum foss personality, see, the mother is not a natrum foss personality. Mother was in a natrum foss state of mind. That state of mind of natrum foss variety, it got transmitted to the genes of the child, and this child is a natrum foss child born with a functional genetic disorder. so do not want to burden others. So that feeling of Nitram Foss is always there, that if I speak something, then I will have a problem. Other person in front of me will be hurt, so I should keep quiet. Ailment from bad news. So that this pregnancy or presence of a boy, presence of a girl child was a bad news for this lady. Ailment from love, disappointment. So being a pregnant lady, I should be appreciated. I should be well valued at home. But this was not at all there. So this is love, disappointment. Then anticipation, whether a boy will come or a girl will come. Throughout pregnancy, there was anticipation. So in this case, all the factors, they worked in the background and created a Natrum Foss personality. Mother was in, and why? Because we are studying this, because very less literature is available. Very less clinical cases are available in Natrum Foss other than giving to acidity. Oh, heartburn ho gaya, sore belching ho gayi, give Natrum Foss and done. But this Natrum Foss, you can use it for genetic disorders also. Mother was in anticipation mode throughout pregnancy as if she was on a test. So this is anticipation ailment from stage fright. So the pregnancy for this lady was almost like sitting on a stage and performing. So she has to perform, and how to perform? She has to deliver a boy child. So this is ailment from stage fright. If a girl is being born, that situation will be highly problematic. If a girl will child, child will be born. Some people are raising hands. If a girl is being born, that situation will be highly problematic. Anticipation, evil as of impending. So something evil is going to come if a girl child is coming. How will I manage my home when husband is not earning well? Anxiety home about. So these are the rubrics which came out of this case. My husband does not support or care for me. Appreciation desire by husband. That is Natrum Foss, clearly mentioned. No care at all in the first pregnancy, girl was born. Still she managed to carry herself. Cheerfulness thunders and lightning wind. Very, very important. Try to understand this rubric. Cheerfulness thunders and lightens when. Now, what is this? Previously, she had a normal pregnancy, she had a normal delivery, everything was normal. But now, what is happening is the situation is quite opposite. The demand is of a boy child, but the situation is different. So now, the situation is like anytime anything can happen, anytime any comment will happen. So, thunders and lightning is what? Sudden any disaster is going to happen. So anytime sudden comment is going to come. So even with that, this lady tried to manage herself well off during this pregnancy. So this is cheerfulness thunders and lightens when. Natrum Foss, due to comfort sensation, still feels cheerful. So this is another feeling of Natrum Foss. Cheerfulness mirror observing herself in front of. See, it is the Natrum Foss who has not done anything outside environment is doing whatever is happening in the outside. The fault is of the outside, but Natrum Foss from inside is very, very pure. It doesn't have any guilt feeling because it doesn't do any wrong thing. But the conscience feeling is there. So this lady felt totally alone and due to comments wanted to shut down herself. So this is delusion. Cellar, he is shut in dark. This defines Natrum Foss. This delusion defines Natrum Foss. And this delusion ranks Natrum Foss up to that level where the physiology could be shut down. And a person could be cut off from the entire world and land up in autism. Basically, what is autism is a withdrawal state where you tend to cut off from the whole world and you are into your own self. You are living in a state of withdrawal from the whole society or from the whole world, because the mother felt that the whole world is going to taunt or torment or torture. So that is why the child went into a state of withdrawal. So this is cellar. Cellar is an underground thing where you are kept, and that is a dark place. So the whole life of Natrum Foss is like this, living in a cellar. That is the perception of Natrum Foss. So this lady always used to hear that I am hearing some or the other comments. So this is delusion, footsteps, hears, room in next. Always there is some or the other person who is trying to give comment. So this lady was always alert. So she felt that she cannot be helped. If she could have retaliated, if she could have rebelliously fought against all these people, she might have got a proper situation. But she did not resist it. She kept things inside. She did not try to communicate. So that was delusion. Helped cannot be. Delusion, imagination sees frightful phantoms. That was the fright which he was having. If what if I deliver a girl child? That was the fright. So that image of that scene was totally there in her pregnancy. What if I deliver a girl child? What if this thing is going to happen? This thing, that thing. See, this delusion, frightful. I have treated one more case of autism very beautifully. The thing in that, there was a big problem with this case. This child was an adopted child. This was an adopted child. So how to get the history from the mother? That was very, very, it was a hard task. But thank God, the lady which adopted this child, she had talked to that the mother of this child, and she narrated the whole history. She said that this lady, when this child was in the womb, her husband used to fight and fight and fight and torture and this thing and that thing, whole pregnancy. When this lady was sleeping, she had dreams that she was being beaten. She used to wake up and she used to cry. So that is the delirium which is going on in the child. And this child, if outside home, the dogs are barking and this child is trying to escape and he's trying to hide in the corner. So this is delirium. Things into action. A normal person will not do such type of things. So if anything you find out of ordinary, that becomes a delirium. Okay. See, for example, I entered through this rubric in many cases. A child who came to me with pneumonia. Okay. Pneumonia. And this mother, I told her, what happened? She said, sir, nothing happened. I asked and asked and asked. There should be some cause. If any effect has happened, there has to be a damn cause. So now what is the cause? Nothing at home, nothing at school. See, there are two areas. Okay. Nothing with kids playing. No incidents. Then what? Then she said, sir, she went to a barber shop. Then I said, then what? Sir, she is very scared of the barber. I said, what is her age? She said, sir, she is 10 years. Why is she scared of the barber? She said, sir, we have to control her. 3-4 people, we have to control her, and then she will cut the hair. She will allow the barber to cut the hair. That much amount of fear. So now what happened? Recently, she had gone for a haircut. Some of the, if we don't poke out deeply, we'll say that ailment from haircut or such type of rubrics are there in our repertory. So we'll try to enter through that. That is all useless. This is delirium, frightful. Normal people will not have fear in such situation. But this child was having that much amount of fear out of proportion. And the reaction to that, you see. So then she came out from the pneumonia like anything within 2 days. So yes, delusion, furniture to be persons imagines night waking on. Anyone could interpret this delusion. Delusion furniture to be persons imagines night waking on. Yes, please. Inputs now. Inputs. Yes, anyone? What is furniture? Why would a person think that a furniture is a person? Why is this false perception developed? What is the need of this perception? Number one, if a person is getting hurt from multiple persons, he does not want to be entertained or he does not want to be in contact with people. So in order to avoid, he tries to imagine. Yes, please. Dr. Sandhya. Yes, please. Any question? Shall I continue?
Yes, sir. Please continue. We will take the questions in the end, sir.
Okay. So, what is the meaning? You have to see each and every word and you have to interpret whatever history I've given. That is the history of Natrum Foss. So now, what is night? Night is end of the day. Night is also interpreted as a sad part of the day or a sad event. Okay, that is night. Waking on means when you are conscious of something. Waking, night waking on. If you realize that the situation outside is very sad, that time you feel that the furniture is a person. Okay. That is the false perception. So Natrum Foss feels that this is single remedy rubric Natrum Foss. Very, very important. This defines Natrum Foss personality. So Natrum Foss person feels that when I am sad, I should not communicate with people. I should not talk. If I talk with people, either I will be hurt or the other person will be hurt. But Natrum Foss has a feeling that I should not hurt the other person. That moral or conscience is there in Natrum Foss. So what patient will speak to you is, hey, sir, I am being hurt always and always by people at home. So when I am alone, with whom to share my feelings? So I tend to talk with the walls. I tend to talk with my toys. I tend to talk with my favorite photo or a photo of my friend. So whatever. That is a delusion. I treated a case of thyroid nodule in which this lady, she had a feeling, or she used to feel that whenever there was any conflict, so when I used to sleep, that time I used to imagine the face of that person on the wall and I used to talk and I used to end that matter in this imagination. So what is this? So this is fancies, person imagining. Okay, so these are fancies. So such is the version of Natrum Foss where Natrum Foss is so much hurt. So he doesn't want to communicate. And when every person need to vomit out his inner negativity, some or the other time or some or the other way. So that negativity has to be removed. So how to do that? Body needs some flushing. So this is the flushing for Natrum Foss. He tries to talk with all favorite things, tries to talk with all dear things which are non-living things. So this is how the Netram Foss perceives. Delusion objects about persons are. So Netram Foss has a feeling that the objects are persons. If I talk to them, Netram Foss has some secret which is there hidden. There was one Netram Foss lady, and she brought her child for nocturnal enuresis, primary. For 2 years, she did not tell the pregnancy history. Sir, I cannot tell. For whole 2 years, I treated by this, I treated by that route, but that nocturnal enuresis was not going. Then finally, I said, either you should speak up or you don't come here. Then she said, sir, during pregnancy, when I saw that my mother-in-law was having an extramarital affair with some other person, that was the thing which was bothering me. And why it was bothering you? Because it was nocturnal enuresis. Where is your boundary disturbed? Sir, this secret I have to preserve for the honor of my family. So this territory of my family should not be disturbed. So that she kept. And after telling me, I entered and so that is the feeling of Netram Foss. Delusion, inanimate objects are. So these are all, there are very few delusions, but these are the defining delusions of Netram Foss. Delusion, inanimate objects are persons. All the dead objects are persons. So with whom Netram Foss tries to communicate. Delusion, hearing illusions of. See what people will say when I deliver a boy child. See, people are talking about me. So all these hearing illusions of. One recently a patient came and he said, sir, I am having sleeplessness. I said, why? What happened? Sir, when I was sleeping one day, just before these episodes of sleeplessness, there is a wall in my bedroom, and just adjacent to it, there is a cow shed where that bull is being tied, and constantly that bull will bang horns on the wall, and constantly I'll be getting disturbed. Then what is the problem? Sir, even though that bull is not doing that banging thing on the wall, still I feel that. I said, any other example? Sir, if suppose night, if I am sleeping and somebody is walking on the roof, and I see that dham dham ka sound, then if I sleep and still if nobody is there, still I tend to get that sound, dham 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 sound. So this is what, this is delusion, hearing illusion of. So even though that sound is not there, but still the patient hears. But I did not enter through this. What was important is, what is happening if this sound is coming? Sir, this sound is piercing in my body. Then theraideon comes. Every time it is not delusion. Sometimes you tend to have that PQRS symptoms also. So I prescribed him theraideon. The moment he said, sir, that sound is piercing in my ear. It is piercing here. It is piercing here. I am getting disturbed, and that is why I got that sleeplessness ka episode. Okay. So delusion images, this is all happened. Delusion, typhoid fever thought he would had. This is one rubric of Netram Foss. How to interpret, how to feel this rubric? Delusion, typhoid fever thought he would have. See, it is mentioned in the mind. So nothing is physical. Whatever is mentioned in the mind of the repertory, nothing is physical. Everything is dynamic, whatever is written in the mind. Now, what is typhoid fever here? All the people who were there outside, they were the typhoid bacilli for this lady. And those people will interfere in my life. What does typhoid bacilli do? They enter they pierce the mucosa, they form a lesion, they form an ulcer. Okay, so she was angry with those people. They are interfering in my life, and because of those people, they have influenced my in-laws, and then because of that, my relationship is being disturbed. So this is typhoid fever thought he would have. This is what I could interpret. There is no other explanation in the light of this case I could get. So this is what is the explanation. So now this situation, which was created in the life of the mother, where she had to keep all this to herself and never to communicate with anyone, and desperate need to escape from the situation, resulting in natrum first personality being born. The communication which she wanted to do was, this is going to be your child and I am bearing it. Give me all the love, recognize me as a part of this family so that everything goes well. They should understand this. See, many of the ladies, they come to you and they say, hey, sir, I do a lot of service at home. I do this. I take care of people at home. I take care of small, small things. But sir, you know what? When these people, they are discussing something in a room, when I enter into this room, suddenly they will stop talking. Now, what do you feel? Sir, what to feel? I'm also part of this family. Then why they are doing like this? So this is again also identity error, because these people, they are not recognizing this lady as a part of the family, even though she is doing all the things to them. She is taking care of everything. Okay, this is lilium tick, identity error. This is the perception of lilium tick. Okay, so they should understand this, but it did not happen and the child lost his identity and went into a withdrawal state. So autism, when you are dealing with, always ask why this child is going into a state of withdrawal. Why this child wants to cut off from the whole world? Why he does not want to receive the signal from the outside world? So what happened to the mother? When the mother was fighting, okay, either the child will be timid. When the mother was being influenced or being controlled, the child will be very, very timid. When the mother was angry during pregnancy, the child will also be angry. Okay. So you have to see the mathematics which is running in the mind of the mother, and you have to find out what is the pathology. So the conclusion is, perception rules our genes. What is beyond genes is our perception. We are not slave of our genes. We fell sick because of our perception. We can repair ourselves with our own perception. See, homeopathy needs only a right perception. I tell you one example. There is a colleague of mine who was having a friend of mine who was having during this lockdown time, he was having some problem. He was having hypothyroidism. His TSH went up to 10. Then he contacted me. I took his history. I prescribed him medicine, but what to do? That medicine came out to be some rare medicine, not at all available there. And I could not send him because courier services were not there. So what did I do is, I said, just open your ears wide and listen to what I am saying to you. The name of the medicine. Just took the name of the medicine and I said, okay, fine, this is the least I could do to you. This is the least help I can give it to you now. Only the vibration of the medicine is important. So this is what I gave it to him, and that TSH after 1 month, it lowered down to 7. But then after that, I gave him the medicine after 1 month. So this is how homeopathy works. Only the vibration is important. So you can have in the future, I can imagine, we can all have pill-less, we can all have dilution-less clinics. If we understand homeopathy deeply, a single right stimulus through any means, even Dr. Raja's DNA is there with me, if I sprinkle a dilution and there his pathology will improve. Because your DNA here is connected with your own self by certain mechanism. So this is what we can do. We can just take a sample of the patient, keep it there, preserve it. And mind you, I've treated with that hair thing also. Only one hair, even that swab of the mouth. You can take the sample of the buccal mucosa cells. You can keep it and you can give the dilution. Such type of experiments also I have done. And mind you, that is possible. That is one area of research which we can do. Anyways, so the negative perception is in mathematical relationship with the pathology, because positive perception or positive thinking is in a mathematical relationship with your health. So now we have to understand the perception in depth and treat any damn genetic disorder. Sky is the limit for us. So now I would conclude my topic, and I would like to thank Father Muller Institution, all the respected staff members and all my friends, everybody in Muller's. It's been a long time. I wanted to come to Muller's. So when I was, when you were showing that video, I called my wife also. I showed that, see, this is Mangalore. So we had plans, but that Corona has damaged and devastated the plans of Mangalore visit. So anyways, soon I'll be coming and meeting you all, and dearly missing you all. So thank you, Father Muller Institutions, and thank you, staff members. Dr. Raja, thank you, and all those people who are associated. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. It was our pleasure. In fact, you took a dynamic trip right now to Mangalore. You left some impressions for us. So it was great listening to you, Dr. D.K. Verma, sir, once again. I know that every time you spoke, you always gave some new insights and new ideas. Fantastic listening to you. I'm getting a lot of replies right now. Is it possible to listen to this lecture once again? Is it possible to see this lecture in the YouTube? So my answer to all those things is it is possible. We will be uploading the video very soon, but we don't know when. So yeah, so in the future, sir, we are very happy to keep this association with you. One of the highlight of today's session, or always been with you, is the analogy, the anamnesis of the case, bringing into a right logical perspective of understanding the case through the rubrics. So it is what I was just going through for a few seconds in my mind when you started speaking, that the path to homeopathy is a very, very narrow one. There are no bargainings here, actually. We cannot say that today is a lot of criticism and things, because there is some part which we actually understand. There is something which we cannot understand. People tend to criticize on the part which we don't understand. Actually, there is time for us, or there is scope for us to understand those things. So it is better to concentrate on those areas which is understanding in our mind. So I again quote one more thing, sir, that it is our mind will understand only, sorry, our eyes will start seeing only the things that our mind knows. So there is a lot of scope today for us to know the new things. And there are a lot of questions waiting for you, sir, Dr. D.K. Verma. I think yes, few sir. Questions we will take, because it's already, we are overshooting the time. What's the difference between forsaken, neglected, and abandoned? I felt it's a genuine question.
Abandoned is a feeling. It is not a delusion. It is not mentioned, I think, in delusion. Mm-hmm. Neglected, delusion is feeling. See, I give you an example. Forsaken is, suppose, yeah, nowadays the situation is like this, ki old age parents are there, and some of the younger generation, they want to shift away from the home to some other place. why for standard of living or to have a freedom of living. So here what these parents will have a feeling is delusion 4 second. Okay, that is 4 second feeling for them because they are being left away. So 4 second is a permanent feeling. Neglected is a temporary feeling. Okay, so right now if I call someone and if that person doesn't respond, then I feel that I am being neglected. And if this perception is permanent, then it becomes a delusion, neglected. See, for example, a child when was not given attention at home goes into school and he feels that, see, because I don't have a fair complexion, the teacher is not being giving attention to me. At work area also, I'm not performing well, or whatever may be the case, the boss is not giving attention. So this becomes deeper and deeper and deeper into genes. So first is a sensitivity which gets affected. Then it is the emotion which develops, or hypersensitivity which develops. And then it goes into a state of delusion where always this feeling persists. So there are some ladies where they complain that husband is not giving attention, but husband says, sir, aur kitna attention dena usko. ठीक है, तो वो दैट नेग्लेक्टेड डिल्यूजन इज देयर इन द परसेप्शन ऑफ द वाइफ एंड अबेंडेंड इज लेफ्ट अवे इन रियल दैट इज अबेंडेंड. अबेंडेंड इज लाइक यू आर इन नीड ऑफ समथिंग एंड दैट पर्सन लीव्स यू फॉर सम सेल्फिश एस्पेक्ट और वट एवर मे बी द थिंग. देन इमेजिन यूर सेल्फ स्टैंडिंग in a desert, what feeling you will get? That is abandoned.
Okay. Yes, sir. One more question here. That is from my very own classmate, Dr. Tendral. She is putting this question. Mm-hmm. Can you differentiate delirium and delusion?
Delirium and delusion, first is sensitivity. Second is hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity going as a fixed perception, that is delusion. Delusion going into action is delirium. Say, for example, I have a fear of something. Suppose outside somebody is there. I have a fear. But nobody is there. Okay, then it becomes a delusion. Even though outside nobody is there, I have a constant feeling that outside somebody is there. Okay. And in order to do that, or in order to escape from this fear, you tend to do certain things which are out of proportion. Say, for example, a person who is given a shot, okay, injection. So how does he react? नॉर्मल पर्सन हाउ डज ही रिएक्ट? अरे सर प्लीज सर, मेरे को नहीं है, पेन है. फियरफुल पर्सन, नहीं नहीं नहीं. अ पर्सन हु इज हैविंग अ डिल्यूजन, वो एंटर नहीं करेगा बिकॉज ऑलरेडी उसको पता है कि उसको लगेगी. हाउ डज अ पर्सन विद डिलीरियम विल डू? ओ, ही विल शाउट एंड डू दिस थिंग एंड दैट थिंग, ही विल मूव हियर एंड देयर, ही विल रन अवे. दैट इज डिलीरियम. डिलीरियम is to be taken where the mind is going haywire. There is no control of the logic. When logic is left far, far beyond and you are completely going impulsively, so that is delirium. Say, for example, one patient was there in coma. So I came to him and I just saw him that he was doing like this or something, some actions from finger he was doing. So I asked the attendant, what is happening with him? He said, sir, wo constantly usko paise ka nuksan hua hai and then he is counting money. So din bhar wo yehi karta rehta hai, wo paise ginta rehta hai. So this is delirium. Wo wahan pe bhi usko usi cheez ke bare mein sochna hai, out of proportion. Arey teri bimar ho gaya yaar, tu uske bare mein dekh. So this is delirium. This is out of proportion. Something which is going out of proportion is delirium.
Fantastic, sir. Thank you. And this is a question which you already answered. That is suppression of boils. Why can't that be the primary cause? You very well answered it, because boils, many children will develop. But suppression leading to complaint, that means it is much before the suppression, the pathology has existed. So, and one of our students, she is asking the question. They have a wrong perception that because a delusion is an English language word, which has been taken into the psychiatry. So they think that delusion means it's always the psychiatry.
Let me correct it. Our repertory, whatever is mentioned, is not at all related to psychiatry. Whatever is our common terminology which we are using now, that is mentioned in our repertory. Okay. The best thing to study is, you look at any damn Hindi serial, choose the words properly, and you will find all the rubrics of our repertory here. Achha, main usko dekhungi, main usko aisa kar dungi. Maliciousness. You find very, very interesting rubrics. Or you go to a bus stand, you go to a railway station, stand there, watch people, what they are doing. Try to find out. Okay, best thing is try to just watch television serials. The Saas Bahu serial, that syndrome, you will find out very, very rich rubrics, you will find out. And the moment you tend to have that habit of framing the rubric, you will learn. Okay, so what was the question?
Yeah, that regarding the delusion.
Okay, so that is to be kept totally away from the psychiatry. Don't mix psychiatry with our mind repertory. Leave aside psychiatry. Okay, that is to be totally left upon. That is not to be delusion. You have to interpret. See, a person is coming to you with allergic rhinitis. Theek hai? He says, sir, I have got this allergic rhinitis. Why? What is the cause? What happens? He says, sir, if I am at home and outside, if four or five houses away, if somebody is burning that fire and smoke is coming, then, sir, here I have this allergy. Then you say, what the hell, man? Why are you having this allergy here? If the person living there is not suffering, then why are you suffering here? So this is the delusion which person is having. Okay. So this is that delusion, injured being injured. So that particular stimulus can injure him over here. That is the delusion. So you have to understand the false perception of the patient. Okay. Some person recently, some big shot person, he came to me. There was no way I could take his history. So I have to only listen to him. What is he saying? So he came to me and he sat and he said, sir, whenever there is this cloudy weather, I have this pain in the neck and this thing. See, a person who is big shot, if you ask him, sir, what is your ego problem? He will never ever reply to you. You cannot even ask, you not even dare to ask. Okay. So he had that perception that, sir, whenever there's this cloudy weather, I have this pain in the neck. Then I said, okay, is it really happening? So, sir, I had this old injury in my back also, that also when there is a cloudy weather, that also hurts. So being a doctor, is it really the thing which should happen in the system? So the cause of pain over here and the pain on the back, that we already know what could be the cause. Other than these things, everything is a delusion. Okay. And mind you, this life itself is a delusion, because nothing is permanent. No perception is truth. Nobody's perception is the truth. Truth is totally different phenomena. Actually, we are all in a big delusion. We are having, or we are living in a delusion. So delusion is everywhere. Whatever you think you do, there is delusion. Some people, they think, I have got this opportunity. Then I should grab it. but I should not tell people. Why? I don't know, something will come and this opportunity will be gone. So that is again a delusion. Why this opportunity will be gone if you tell people? Okay, one person got there are so many things, so much things are there. Those are fixed in the mind. So we are all having those delusions. So life is a delusion and we are living a delusional life. Okay, so we are in a delusion. Truth is something else. Okay, that we don't know. We even don't know that we don't know the truth. Okay, so that is, everything is a delusion. So whatever patient is talking about, that is a delusion. Some people will say, sir, this weather is, this damp weather, I always get sick. Why? Mother Nature is there to help you or to harm you. You have come from Mother Nature, then what the hell and why the hell will Mother Nature will try to harm you? So this is delusion, injured, being injured by surrounding. So this person has a feeling that surrounding environment is going to injure him. Naja, hyoscyamus and lachesis. Out of these three, you have to select one medicine. Ask him, are you sensitive to tight clothes? Nada, then give hyoscyamus. If you are, filter out lachesis and naja. Hot is lachesis, chilly is naja. Lachesis is aggressive, naja is mild. Naja is very conscientious, naja is very, is having very, very self negative, devaluating things in the mind. Lachesis is far, far away from such reproaches and all conscience or moral feeling. So it is very easy to differentiate.
Yes, sir. Thank you. So on my behalf, so I conclude this. So thank you so much, Dr. D.K. Verma, sir, for filling us and enriching us today with a lot of experiential learning. Thank you. Over to Dr. Helena.
Thank you.
On behalf of the organizing team, Pro Vision 2020, I express my gratitude and respect for our distinguished speaker, Dr. Divya Kumar Verma, for sparing his invaluable time for us and enlightening us with his commendable presentation illustrating cases with importance of the rubric delusion.
Just a second. This name of mine itself creates an identity error for me many times. Because the spelling in Hindi is different and in English it comes out to be this. So there is a identity conflict from my name which comes. Okay, yes, thank sir. You. Thank you, doctor.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. I would also like to thank the moderator for the session, Dr. Rajchandra Ji. I would like to thank the administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krasta, principal, Dr. Shiv Prasad K, and vice principal, Dr. ESJ Prabhu Kiran, for their valuable support for Pro Vision 2020. I express my gratitude to the webinar organizing team headed by Dr. Dheeraj Fernandez, who have been working hard to make this webinar series a successful one. Finally, I thank all the delegates who have dedicated their time in being a part of this session actively. We have the best of session in upcoming days to come, so stay tuned with us. Dear delegates, tomorrow we have a session by Dr. G. Nagendra Babu presenting on the topic Relevance of Diversified Prescriptions. Thank you. Have a good night.